Welcome.
Now we are going to find the cube root of 1.
Don't say that even knowing cube root of 1 is 1. That much is not sufficient. Please wait. Have patience. You can able to know something more. Let us see. Let us assume that we are not knowing what is cube root of 1. So let us assume let cube root of 1 equals to x. So if we can find the value of x, then we can able to know what is the cube root of 1. From here, by cubing both sides, we can write x cube equals to 1. Or we can say x cube minus 1 equals to 0. From here, we can write x minus 1 into x square plus x plus 1 equals to 0. From here, we can say x minus 1 equals to 0. This implies x equals to 1. This we are knowing from lower classes. This is called the arithmetical cube root of 1. Now we will check this one. See, x square plus x plus 1 equals to 0. By using Sridhar Acharya's formula, we can say x equals to minus 1 plus minus root of 1 minus 4 into 1 into 1 by 2. That is minus 1 plus minus root of minus 3 by 2. So actually we are getting two values. X, one value we got this one. From there we are getting x equals to minus 1 plus root of minus 3 by 2. Another value we are getting x equals to minus 1 plus minus root of minus 3 by 2. So actually we are getting three values of x. This 1 minus 1 plus root of minus 3 by 2 and minus 1 minus root of minus 3 by 2. These are actually three cube roots of unity or 1. This is known as arithmetical cube root and these two are known as complex cube roots of 1. Now see one more interesting thing. See here. Let us assume this one is omega. This symbol we are denoting by omega. Omega equals to minus 1 plus root of minus 3 by 2. So what will be omega square? Squaring what we are getting? 1 minus 3 minus 2 root of minus 3 by 4 equals to minus 2 minus 2 root of minus 3 by 2 equals to minus 1 minus root of minus 3. Now this one was by 4, so this one will become by 2. Okay, and see, this one is this one. So if this is omega, then this one will be known as omega square. So in this way we can say one of the root, cube root is of 1 is omega and the other one is omega square. Now we can see one more interesting thing.
Let us assume that now let us assume this one is omega, that is minus 1 minus root of minus 3 by 2 equals to omega. So squaring both sides, what we are getting? 1 minus 3 plus 2 root of minus 3 by 4 equals to omega square, that is minus 2 plus 2 root of minus 3 by 4, that is equals to minus 1 plus root of minus 3 by 2. So what we are finding, that if this one is omega, this one is omega square, and if this one is omega, then this one will be omega square. When this one is omega, this one will be omega square. And this is the peculiar to this complex number. It, you cannot find any such number in real numbers where it is possible. If 2 square is 4, then 4 square cannot be 2. But here omega square is omega, and omega is omega square. Omega square is also this one. So in this way, we are getting 3 cube roots of 1. You have to remember these 3 roots. These 3 roots are 3 roots. 1, omega, omega square. Again I am repeating. If you say this one omega, this one you can say omega square. If you are saying this one you can say omega square. Now see, omega into omega square. Omega into omega square equals to this one into this one. If we are doing a square minus b square, it becomes 1 minus minus 3 by 4. That is 4 by 4. That is equals to 1. So we are getting omega cube equals to 1. And we are going, that is our assumption also. Omega is cube root of 1. So omega cube we are getting 1. Again, if we are doing omega plus omega square, what we are getting? This one plus this one. See, the LCM will be 2 minus 1 plus root of minus 3 minus 1 minus root of minus 3. This is equals to, this 2 will cut, minus 2 by 2. And this is equals to minus 1. So omega plus omega square equals to minus 1. So from here, what we can able to learn? So again I am repeating once more that there are 3 cube roots of unity. Okay? Only one is omega, another is omega square, and third one is the arithmetical cube root, that is 1. And from here we are getting 1 plus omega square equals to 0. This relationship you have to remember. Either you can say omega plus omega square equals to minus 1, or remember 1 plus omega square equals to 0. So these are the 3 cube roots of unity, 1, omega and omega square. Now quickly see another relationship of omega. Omega to the power 1 equals to omega. Omega to the power 2 equals to omega square. Omega cube equals to 1. omega to the power 4 equals to omega cube into omega equals to 1 into omega equals to omega. Omega to the power 5 equals to omega cube into omega square equals to 1 into omega square equals to omega square. Omega to the power 6 equals to omega cube whole square equals to 1 square and equals to 1. So in this way you can say omega to the power m, for any value of m, whenever m is an integer, it will be equals to either 1 or omega square. Hope you can be able to understand. Thank you.